Hey, welcome back to Sister Circle Live. It is time now for our full circle discussion. And because today is Black Women's Equal Pay Day, we want to take some time to bring awareness to this issue. Black women have to work 8 months longer to earn the same amount as their white male counterparts, and on average earn 38% less for equal work, a disparity that cannot be ignored given the fact that more than 80% of Black mothers are the primary breadwinners for their households. There are a number of campaigns circulating on social media to bring awareness to this inequity, but how can we make this issue more than just a hashtag? This is very heavy today.
Yep.
Because I'm even mad that we even have this day.
Right.
Yeah. I got to tell you, this day is a piece of, I don't know, it's a mess. And we talk about it, like we touch on it a lot down here.
Yeah.
But it's frustrating because, you know, it's almost like anything else that you can't change immediately.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know? So, like you said, Rashawn, first of all, why do we have to talk about this at all?
Right.
And, you know, August 7th, 8 months, that's the whole, you know, reason, 8 months. We'd have to work 8 more months extra to make what white men make. That's what the whole August 7th is.
Yes, you know? Yes.
But what I find interesting, and I did a little research on it, just so that I can speak on something with a little more, to go a little more in depth and to enhance my understanding.
Right, of
make
why.
Heads or tails of what's happening. Mm-hmm. My conclusion is just purely racism and sexism, you know, something that we've been dealing with systemically, which is the issue, is systemic. It's not surface. So that makes it a lot harder to kind of deal with. According to a survey on Forbes.com, leanin.org/... hashtag 38% is an organization that's trying to eradicate this issue.
And bring awareness.
And bring awareness to this issue. But I don't know if awareness is the issue. I think awareness is almost like a shadow of, to kind of shadow what we already know, because everybody already kind of knows this. It's like an unspoken knowing thing. So they did a survey in conjunction with Survey Monkey in partnership also with the National Urban League, and they found out, well, they came up with the statistics that 1 in 3 Americans are not aware that Black women make 38% less than white men, 21% less than white women, and that half of Americans don't know that Black women get less. I don't know if I believe that, but I mean, that's their statistics. I'm not saying that they're not wrong. I believe that that's what they came up with, but I don't know if I believe that working inside the infrastructure of a company, that people don't know that Black women are the lowest on the totem pole. And I think that it's a matter of knowing, but because nothing's happening, no one's moving behind it. I think that it's a disservice to our families. You pay us less, but then you expect us to still pay for the same things that everyone else has to pay for with the money that we don't have.
Yeah.
Then you wonder why we're in debt.
Oh,
you wonder
yes.
why our communities are failing. And let me also add, and I'll pass the microphone, but let me also add that part of the reason why we are suffering, and not just because of the fact that they know that this is incorrect, is because, you know, that they know that they should be paying us equal, not more, equal.
Right.
I think that is, I don't want to say it's an agenda, a hidden agenda, but it just seems very peculiar that our Black men are 6 times more likely to go to jail, and they also are 19% more likely to have, well, they, not more likely, they get longer sentences than any other race. So our men are in jail. You're keeping our men in jail. You're breaking up our families. And then you're, which essentially will break up our communities. Also, Mark H. Morio, the president of the National Urban League, said that if we were to be paid the same, what we were supposed to be paid, Black women would make, if Black women were to be paid the same that, that everybody else was getting, we would make $870,000 more than what we're making over the course of our career. That's almost $1 million that we're owed over the course of our career. So imagine what our families are suffering from because of what you are not, you're not giving us. Not something that we're not earning, that you're not giving us, that you're just simply saying, no, I'm not going to give it to you.
And I think a lot of us, because we're not being paid what we are supposed to be getting paid, we're going to school. And we're getting more and more degrees just to try to get on the level of someone who has an undergraduate degree, our counterpart, our white counterpart, and we have a PhD just to get on the level. And I feel like in the workplace, our competence is questioned, our authority is undermined, it's always looked at as anger.
Intimidation.
And also, I believe that our brilliance is very intimidating
yes.
to people.
Oh, absolutely.
And it is a fear that we may have to compete on the same level playing ground
yeah.
without privilege.
Mm-hmm.
So,
ooh.
You're right.
Say that again, Miss
Ali.
There
is a fear
that's right.
that we would all have to play on the same field
mm-hmm.
without privilege being involved.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Black women are brilliant, and this mm-hmm. is not to discredit any other race. Black women are the most well-educated group in this country.
Hard-working.
We work hard, we lead our families, mm-hmm. and that is intimidating to so many people.
Mm-hmm.
So the reason why we have this day, we have to make people
right.
aware. We have to say what we feel from
yeah.
our hearts so that people can start to change.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I've said this once before many of times on this very set, and I'm going to say it again. When you're going up for your interviews, be well informed across the board nationally what that particular job pays.
Mm-hmm.
I think a lot of times we're so happy to just get the job. You know,
mm-hmm.
we take a lot lower. Know that it's okay to negotiate.
Right.
It's perfectly fine. You don't have to go for the first thing that they put on the table. Often, the first amount that they put on the table is the very lowest
right.
that they can offer. And then you sit there and you smile and you talk about how great you are. You go through all of your accolades and you're scared to negotiate your deal.
Mm-hmm.
You better get it on the front end because it will not be a back end.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And if I may add, I would say it's absolutely imperative that we do discuss it because just like with anything, i.e. slavery, people are apt to say that slavery never happened because they don't want to discuss it. We have to keep it on the forefront of our minds. So we have to remind people, absolutely, we get paid less. We're not going to stand for it. We deserve more. So you have to keep, thank you for the day.
Mm-hmm.
But I will also say I employ other women to start to open businesses so that we can
hire
each other. And then you know that when this woman come in here, she's qualified to have this particular position.
Mm-hmm.
Hire her and pay her her worth,
mm-hmm.
opposed to having her to fight with you
yes.
about how much she deserves. So I say, sis, you know, open up your own company. Start, you know, investigate women who are capable of maintaining that job. Hire other sisters. Support sisters who have black, businesses.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, you want to have something there that you can pour and sow into the community.
Entrepreneurs.
Thank
yes,
you.
Become entrepreneurs. Use your brilliance that Rashawn spoke of,
yeah.
that we're speaking of,
mm-hmm.
to create your own revenue streams,
yeah.
because then that cannot be taken from you. Create your own money.
Absolutely.
Yes. We'd love to hear how you feel. Send us your thoughts at Sister Circle TV on all of our social platforms. Come.